could be the fifth B, could be the G. You know, if we would start them in, or, but we didn't, we decided to start on the ninth, and the ninth is, that's the, and then bringing the melody down, goes into the flat five, and then the perfect fifth. I'm using a little mute technique with the pick in between on the E. And then, here's a... Now you have an E minor. And it, instead of playing an E minor this way, it actually, with distortion, for some reason, has a cool sound to it. Here. There's a little bit of a chromatic movement there. And again, you have a cool chord shape every time. I mean, this first chord, which has the E with a C on top, that could pretty much be an inversion of a C chord. And the perfect fifth, E, and the flat five. So you get all these cool chords. And then the melody goes. So I shift all the way down to the lower octave on F sharp and G. And then it goes to a C, but it has this Lydian-ish type of sound in the melody. So. So from C, that's one way. And then finally, a B to resolve. So like this. Yeah.